Hey, what's up guys, it's Kaustubh here and today we will be taking a look at the Bliss ROM version 12.10 and this is a Android 10 based custom ROM for the OnePlus 3D. As per the drill guys, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. With that being said, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So firstly guys, as always, we will be taking a look at the about info of this Bliss ROM which I have flashed on the OnePlus 3D. So here in settings, in about phone, firstly we get this cool Team Bliss animation which looks really cool, I should say. Other than that, we have the Bliss version, ROM version, which is Bliss version 12.10. So I will just quickly go here. So this ROM version is 12.10, which I have installed. Then we have the maintainer, that is Deepak Jr. He is the maintainer of this specific ROM, and the build date is 24th July. So this is the latest build which I have installed, at least as of now. And coming to the Android version, here again we get the latest version of Android, that is Android 10. The insecurity patch level is 5th July 2020, so that's the latest one. August one will also be coming soon to this ROM as well. Then talking about the build number, we have got the build number and kernel. So kernel is also a Lineage OS based kernel, as we can see here. So that's about it for the ROM info. Second thing is the display and the ROM customization that this ROM provides. So by default guys, if we go into the settings in display, so here we have all the basic settings like always, and throughout the whole UI we have got this cool animations. It looks really cool. So here we got all the basic settings: night light, adaptive brightness, screen timeout. Lock screen timeout is also something which I'm seeing a lot on new custom ROMs. So that's there. Screen attention is there. Font size, display size, all of them are pretty self-explanatory. We have also got the dark theme option right here in the display settings. So that's for the display settings. Now if I go into the ROM settings, here we get a separate tab called as a Blissify. So here we have all the ROM settings. So we get status bar, quick settings, animations, buttons, lock screen, gestures, notifications, themes and more. So customization wise, this ROM is pretty much there, and this whole UI looks pretty similar to that of MSM Extended, which I have reviewed earlier. So some sort of a vibe of MSM Extended is present also in the quick settings. If you can see, it is similar to this. Random colors are similar to that of MSM Extended. Nextly, third thing is about security, that is face unlock. So face unlock is present on this ROM. If I go into security right here, then as you can see, we have got the face unlock option. So face unlock can be enabled, and I will just quickly show you. It works really fast. So face unlock is still present on this one. Other than that, another thing that I would like to show you is with the Volt. So if you guys can see, I have the Volt symbol right here. So VoLT is working absolutely fine. I have the Airtel India SIM card in the OnePlus 3T in SIM slot 1 currently. So I will go in mobile network quickly and show you that Volt is working absolutely fine. No problems with VoLTE as well. Fourth thing is the default launcher that this ROM comes with. So guys, this is the launcher which we get to see in a lot of Android 10 custom ROMs. So this is quite a common launcher. It works pretty flawless, like there are no any lags or stutters as I have noticed in my testing period. And talking about performance, then I have done an Antutu benchmark test and the scores were pretty good, I should say. So here are the scores: 1,91,116. So this is the score that this ROM scored in Antutu benchmark. And benchmarks, as always guys, don't translate to real world performance. Real world performance may vary a lot compared to this benchmark numbers. Next we're talking about is the stock camera that comes with this ROM by default. I was guys surprised to see this Google camera go. So this is like a light version of Google camera, I should say, and it is available on the Play Store, but this ROM by default gives you that. So this is the default camera that comes with this ROM, and it is pretty basic. It doesn't have a lot of features as such. So yeah, this is the stock camera. But as always guys, I always suggest you to go for Gcam mod version 7.3. it's the best out there. You can get really stellar performance from this Gcam mod. I have made a video about it, you can watch it right here. So always use Gcam mod. So finally guys, I would like to talk about is the battery life. And battery life has been pretty average, I should say. It is just like other custom ROMs. It is averaging at around 4 hours. So 4 hours is the average screen on time which I was getting. Like some days I was getting 5 hours also, but on an average, if you see, I was getting around 4 hours of screen on time. So here in the battery menu, we get this cool battery animation. I really like this kind of battery animations. Then adaptive battery is present. then battery charge warning is present, that is just like smart charging, I guess. Then battery saver and performance, so we get this kernel performance modes right here. You can set it on any mode as per your liking. You can put it into performance for gaming, so yeah, this is present right here. Then other than that, smart charging is also present, so that's a good thing. You can restrict your battery percentage from overcharging, so that's there. So yeah, this is the battery menu that you get in this ROM. So finally guys, concluding the video, what I think about this ROM is that I get a pretty similar vibe to that of MSM Extended, but it is a much better ROM than MSM Extended because I was getting a couple of bugs in that one. But nonetheless, this ROM is pretty good and stable. Battery life is average, I should say, like not that great. And as always guys, my suggestion, if you ask for which is the best custom ROM for OnePlus 3T, as always I would suggest you to try out the Skydragon OS, which I have uploaded a video already. You can check it out right here. It is the best Android Pie ROM that you can get. It is much better than the C-Android version 5.10. Then for Android 10, if you want an Android 10 based custom ROM guys, then you can go for the Evolution X 4.4. It is a stellar ROM, I should say. You can also check that video right here. I have done a full review of that ROM, so do check that video out too. So these are my two ROM recommendations which I would give you guys. So that's about it for this video of Bliss ROM version 12.10. I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, then please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more awesome content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.